went behind this guy, checked his background, and he was a prisoner. And even on how he got his wife, the wife came with other people to come and see him in prison. And most people, because they get saved when they're in prison, God spoke to him about her. And he proposed her while he was behind bars. And she went away, and she came back and gave him the answer. They're married now. He's staying in, I think he's staying in the UK. But he's got a church now somewhere in the States, but he's Nigerian. And you know, that's why there's another song that he sings. It's a known song, but usually because we South Africans, we don't pay attention to other people's languages. We usually are confined to our own languages. That's why they come to our countries and dominate us, because we only want to know what we know. And when I was listening to his testimony, he was giving a testimony about why he wrote that other song, not this one. He wrote it because he realizes that he didn't deserve even his wife because of the life that he lived. But because of what God has did in his life, and has done in his life, he believes that he just has to praise God. And now he's using his voice, and he's also preaching. And his church is growing. He's already released a lot of songs after being in jail. So it's a touching testimony. So I like to listen to such people, because I believe that he's got a testimony before he starts singing, just his life. Because even the song says, the splendor of the Lord, I see it all around me. Because I can see the arm of the Lord upon my life. Amen. Today I want us to, let's just stand up and open with prayer, because we've not done that. We're still waiting for you guys to come. Let's just thank God for moving us out of our offices and bringing us here. Father, we thank you. Your faithfulness is always true. We thank you, Father, for drawing us into the knowledge of your word, for helping us and preparing us to come and not mind what is going on around us, to only mind about the power that is in your word. And Father, I believe that you're going to speak to us. You're going to, release us from the bondages. Whatever kind of bondages we might be in, some of them we don't even acknowledge that they are in them. And Father, I believe that you're going to disconnect us from those through your word, by your spirit, now, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you for the deployment right now from the angels. I believe that, Father, as we're going to speak, you're going to confirm everything that we are going to say by your spirit.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Jesus. May be seated. I just want to thank God for his words today. And I thank God for speaking to me. I was telling my wife the other day that if God can start talking to me the way he talks to me these days, if God can start revealing himself the way he speaks to me, that will excite me about my calling, because I don't want to speak my mind. I want to speak the mind of God.
Amen.
And I believe that the little word that we're going to share is going to uplift, it's going to disconnect us from our little bondages. Because even as we are Christians, we are still bound in other things. We need God's grace to release us from those things. If we can open our Bibles, let's open Matthew 24. We're going to read from we can start from verse 8 down to 10. I want you to take this. Those who will come throughout the week, even on Friday, and even maybe be with us on Sunday, they will hear the same word, because I believe that God has something to help certain people. Avoid the trap of being offended. That is the word today. Avoid the trap of being offended. Jesus said in the last days, many will be offended. And many will repel even against the very same gospel they claim to have received. Mm. Avoid the trap of being offended. It closes many doors in your life. And it closes even your eyes. You can't see clearly as a Christian because of offense. Mm. Matthew 24, you can read from verse 8 up to 10.
All this is but the beginning, the early pains of the birth pains of the intolerable anguish. Then they will hand you over to suffer affliction and tribulation and put you to death. And you will be hated by all nations for my name's sake. And then many will offend and repel and will begin to distrust and desert him whom they ought to trust and obey.
Can you go through verse 10 again?
And then many will be offended and repelled, and will begin to distrust and desert him whom they ought to trust and obey, and will stumble and fall away and betray one another and pursue one another with hatred.
This is not talking about non-Christians. It's talking to Christians themselves. In the last days, people will be offended, and people will repel even against the very same gospel they received. They will even repel against one another. They will start chasing one another because they will feel betrayed by their brothers and their sisters, by their pastors, and then the end of it is hatred. End up hating one another. But we are singing, worshiping songs, and raising our hands up before God. But we are filled with offense. Some, this offense has been there for 20 years, 30 years. You can't even worship God freely because you are offended. You've been offended by your aunt that you don't even know. But you come into the house of God, you can't even raise your hands and worship God because you feel this offense. Some you will be hurt inside the church by some people that you don't even know. And you're always protective. You build a wall around you. You can't allow other people to penetrate inside your life and love you and be loved by you. You only receive, you can't give anything back because you've got this wall around you. Mm. You are like the Dead Sea. Mm. You know, when I was in Israel, I was told that the Dead Sea, the reason why it produces only salt is because it doesn't have life in it. Mm. It's not like the Sea of Galilee and the Sea and the Jordan River, because the Sea of Galilee receives water from River Jordan, and then it produces plants and fish can live in there. But in the Dead Sea, you can't find that. Mm. It's a Dead Sea. It only receives, but it cannot give anything away. So if you are a Christian and are like that, you are receiving preaching, teaching, the Word of God every now and then, left, right, and center. But the love that is supposed to exude out of you, it cannot. You are even preventing other people from receiving the salvation because you've got nothing to give. Mm. You're filled with offense. Mm. Revelation chapter 3. Jesus. Avoid the trap of being offended. Mm. You can be prayed for and receive healing today. But because of offense, the devil uses that gate all the time. He comes back. You come back next week, you're still sick. But they prayed for you, you felt you were healed. Mm. Let's read verse 18. Chapter 3 of Revelation, verse 18.
I counsel you to purchase me gold refined and tested by fire, that you may be truly worthy, and white clothes to clothe you, and to keep the shame of your nudity from being seen, and slave to put on your eyes, and salve to put on your eyes, that you may see.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
As a child of God, you are like gold that needs to be refined. When we read earlier, it said you'll be put in prison. You'll be killed for my name's sake. So if you don't have troubles and problems, trials and tribulations, if you don't have people offending you, what kind of a Christian are you going to be? If you don't allow God to rebuke you, to prune you and shape you, every little thing you've got, sensitive skin, every little thing that touches you, shivering like that, but in the Kunkwa, the Kunkwa, there's this, what do you call it?
Beetle.
Beetle, but what do you call it in your language? Where to? I don't know what I'm
talking
about. So if you are that kind of a Christian, you've got knowledge of the truth. You are pumped with the word of God for years, but you've not reached the level of that truth because you lack love. You are offended all the time. The word of God here in Revelation says, therefore I counsel you to purchase for me gold refined and tested by fire. As a child of God, you need to go through the fire. The fire is the trials and tribulations in life. If you don't want to go through that, you will always be rough. You will be a gold or a child of God that is rough. You are this gold that is not refined. The gold, when you say refined, it pulls out from the fire. They put all those chemicals and the salve and everything that they are talking about here. It comes out shining.
Yeah.
You need to come out like that. This week, you know, I've been pondering about the deaths that we see happening of, you know, popular people and even people that we know. And we see this bombings that happen in Kenya where 40 something people just lost their lives just like that once. You saw it in the news. You know, that should, as a Christian, should tell you that your life is not only a journey, as you say it only with your mouth. Even when you go to sleep, you are taking a journey because you might not wake up.
Yeah.
So you need to prepare yourself, remove this offense even before you go to sleep, because you might not wake up. And if you open your eyes in eternity, you close them here, you go to sleep. When you open them, you are in on the other side. And when they're offended, Jesus will remind you of Matthew 24, verse 10. Say, many will be offended in the last days. And they'll repel even against the very same religion that they stand for. I would like to stop here today. If you want to receive this again, I think we can, if God allows us, we'll talk about it again on Friday. Allow yourself to be like gold. Go through the fire. As a Christian, you need to go through the fire. There's no way you can avoid trials and tribulations. You are like clever. The Kukwa player. But in the Kukwa. Yeah, let him talk about it. Yes, people, you know what? We choose it. And it leaves what it was doing. We've got Christians who are like that. I'm offended. When we say, let's stand up and worship God, they can't even raise their hands to their God because they are offended. They've got things that have offended and that we don't even know. You go to sleep and you don't wake up. You die by that being offended. It's not going to be a good story. I was telling my wife yesterday, I see this person I used to know. And all along I thought she's alive. I see her on Facebook and say, this lady is still alive. And 1, 2, 3, I see her profile picture on her friend's profile. And I was like, maybe because they are friends. You know, maybe I missed her birthday. And all of a sudden when I was chatting to the friend says, when was the last time you spoke to this one? We are getting here in this coming weekend. Why? And she started relating. That you, do you know that she was even pregnant? Because she's not married and whatever. She was pregnant and she spent many years not having children. So, all of a sudden she became pregnant. And she discovered when she went to remove the womb, the doctor told her, you want me to remove the womb? Yeah, there's a baby in there. And this month was the 8th month. She went there because there were complications. And what they did, they just removed the baby. The baby's still alive. And she went into some intensive care unit. And then, I mean, the lady herself, she was taken. After they removed the baby, they took her to some, she went into a coma or something like that. And yet she passed on. I'm talking about a vibrant, very active person. Her friend was even saying, you know, this lady, why not to be a fighter? When I saw her in that intensive care unit, I thought she would fight death. And I started looking at the comments of people. People don't believe that this lady passed away. She was a lecturer, a motivational speaker, a radio, what. She was all these things in one person. But she died. So when you are offended as a Christian, I say, going to sleep is like a journey. We always say we are on a journey. So even when you go to sleep, you are taking a journey. So if you go into that sleep offended, you open your eyes, you are on the other side. What are you going to tell God? God will say, yes, you spent many years saying you worshiping me, saying you are my child. But I've never known you, because always when I look at you, I see a heart that is filled with hatred, betrayal, and rebellion because of offense. So watch the trap of being offended. Let's rise up and open our hearts and ask God. You know, when this came, today when I came in there, I ended up asking God for forgiveness. I said, God, whatever I allowed in my heart to offend me, that blocked me even to hear when you talk to me, I come against it now. I don't want to be like that. I don't want to be that kind of a Christian. If I have to go through rough things, I know because they are preparing me for another level. I have to allow those things to happen in my life. I must not allow offense to be part of my life. When people look at me, they must see me as a role model. They must not look at me and see this grumpy Christian. I said, if you are that kind of a Christian, you're like the Dead Sea. The Dead Sea cannot give life. It's dead. I went into that water. It's like when you are in there, it's nice to be a piece of a mat. You must sink and read a newspaper. It's a nice experience. But it's dead. There's no life in that water. But the example that was given was the Sea of Galilee produces life. It receives from the River Jordan and others, and it produces plants and there's fish that can live in there. But the Dead Sea cannot. So a Christian who is like that is a Christian who receives love but cannot give love back. You know, Jesus, you know, he forgave everybody. He forgave even that person who pierced a spear on the side of his body. He forgave even those who rejected him when he needed them most. You know, the disciples, like Peter who denied him, like others who fled when they came to collect Jesus. John followed from a distance because he was afraid to come no closer because Jesus would be taken to some place. But he gave all that away because he trusted in the love of his Father. God loved us so much, yet when we still see us, and he gave his Son. But as Christians, we are fake most of the time. We cannot keep the same kind of love. We talk about these big terms, we talk about what agape, we don't even understand what agape means. Agape means unconditional love. So, do you know, when those kind of people say you scratch my back, I scratch yours. If you don't love me, I don't love you. The Bible says, love even those who curse you and spite you. Love them. That's exactly what Jesus did. Avoid the trap of offense. The trap of the devil. He blocks you from receiving blessings from God because you're always offended. Somebody hurt you years ago. We don't even know that person. Release those people in your heart that are holding you hostage. They are messengers of the devil. The devil is using the names of those people to hold you. Always, when you see somebody who looks like the person who hates you, you even hate that person.
Yes.
You're trapped. I pray the cry before God. I say, God, if there's anything, I know we fall into that trap many times. If there is any offense in me, it's a sin to be offended. I'm asking you to forgive me. Some have been offended by their own children, by their husbands and their wives. Every day you're forcing the laughter to come out in your house, but you know, long time ago, 15 years ago. Can we ask God to have mercy on us? Let's release these people. These names that are written in our hearts and in our spirits, let's release them, let them go. And allow God to fill you with his love. You can come to the full knowledge of God and the truth of God. But if you lack love, the Bible says you are like nothing. Fill your life and your heart with the love of God.
I want.
Can we? These are the songs that I know, people don't know them. But there's this.